said, get your suitcases. We only had one each. Get your suitcases. We're approaching Holland. And I remember looking out of the window and seeing houses on stilts. And that was Holland. And at that point, I asked for my parents. And there was an older girl on the in the compartment. And she laughed at me. She pointed her finger and laughed. And because she knew, and I didn't, that the parents were no longer on the train.
Imagine a world where 10,000 children were rescued from the Holocaust by the kindness of strangers. In November 1938, just months before the start of World War II, Adolf Hitler unleashed the dogs of racial war in his own country. In a series of pogroms forever known as Kristallnacht, the Night of Broken Glass. Nazi stormtroopers murdered and arrested Jewish citizens. They burned hundreds of synagogues. They destroyed thousands of Jewish shops and homes, including a Jewish orphanage in Berlin. Immediately, a plan was launched to transport Jewish children and other young people at risk from the Nazis' grip.
Dear Prime Minister Chamberlain, we, as an assembly of groups working on behalf of Jewish refugees, write to you to appeal for the transportation of child refugees to the state of Great Britain. These innocent children come from areas in Nazi possession, including but not limited to Germany, Poland, and Czechoslovakia. They live in lands where they are under threat of deportation and inhumane deaths. We have previously appealed for the movement of refugees to Palestine, but this bill was rejected. This time, the situation is too dire to ignore. We must act. As Victor Hugo once said, not being heard is no reason for silence. We cannot turn our backs on these children again. Before war breaks out and it is too late, we plead to you, please, do not let these children suffer. Help us bring them to safety in the borders of this state. Sincerely, Simon Marks, from the Movement for the Care of Children from Germany.
Of November 1938, addressed to the people and state of Great Britain. As of November 21st, 1938, the British Parliament has decided to house Jewish refugee children in its country. In order to do this, the British Parliament and the Movement for the Care of Children from Germany met to debate and agree on a bill that allowed these said refugees to enter Britain with the use of a temporary passport. Children from Poland, Austria, Germany, Czechoslovakia, and the Free City of Danzig will be allowed to enter the country. Britain decided that there will be absolutely no adult refugees. As of right now, we are asking the people of this country to sponsor children or to allow a place for these minors to stay. These children will be entering the country without their parents, without everything but a few of their belongings, and most without knowledge of the English language. I am personally asking the people of Britain to open their hearts and minds and allow these children a place to rebuild their lives. This is truly their last opportunity for survival. Here is a chance of taking the young generation of a great people. Here is a chance of mitigating, to some extent, the terrible suffering of their parents and their friends. Thank you for all of your support and consideration. Samuel Hoare.
To whom it may concern, I have heard that your agency is organizing a process called Kinder Transport. I feel that it would be a great opportunity to find refuge for my three children, and I was wondering if there is any way to allow them to participate. I only want the best for my darlings, and I believe that this may be their last chance for survival. Please respond soon. We wait in anguish every day. Many regards, Heidi Schmidt.
Jewish Welfare and Youth Care Agency, we hereby notify you that the English Chance War on which you have asked your child, Anna Brown, to participate will leave on Monday, June 5th, 1939. It will depart from Berlin. Meeting place Monday, June 5th, 1939 at 7 o'clock a.m., Schleicher Bahnhof. Entrance on Brewster Street, special waiting room. Your permit number of your child is 3419. Yours truly, the Jewish Welfare and Youth Care Agency.
Left to Vienna and is heading to Belgium. At this stop, we will be picking up more children. I've heard rumors from the other kids on board that we might not be allowed off at this stop. Claudia, a girl I have befriended, told me that her brother was sent to England on the train, and when he wasn't allowed off, the citizens of the town came to the train station and gave the passengers biscuits and hot chocolate. I hope Patrick and I are this lucky. I would like to be able to feed him a little more than I am right now. We were allowed one suitcase each, so there wasn't much room for food when we were packing. Caring for an infantile sibling is not uncommon, Claudia tells me, as there are no parents allowed on the train. Although, the Red Cross nurses on board are tending to us very well. The faces of the other kinder range from excited to worried. I can understand the latter as we do not know what awaits us. It's even worse for those that are unguaranteed, children without guardians or sponsors to receive them, and rely on charitable donations through the Refugees Children's Movement. Patrick and I were lucky enough to have guardians that can pay the £50 fee required to care for kinder. It's so saddening knowing that most of the children on this train have already lost their parents, as priority on the trains is given to the homeless and orphaned. I am so grateful for my spot and for the comfort that I am not like those other children because you are both safe at home. A few minutes ago, I witnessed a girl, about age 16, tell a little boy why he's really on the train. It broke my heart seeing the realization spread across his face. Some children are told prior to the trip of their fate and why they are separated from their parents. Others, like the little boy, are lied to protect them. Again, I am so grateful. See you soon. Love, Kristen.
Dear Hans, I miss you so much. Life has been extremely hard since you left. Your father was deported to Dachau, and I am all alone. I count the days until we can see each other again. I cannot say much else. You must know why. Please write soon. I hope with all of my heart that you are doing well. Many kisses. Mom.
Mother and Papa, I have just arrived in England and it has felt like a lifetime since Patrick and I left on the train. Since the last letter I have written, a month has passed and I have arrived safely at my new family's house. Patrick and I have been separated and he is in the hands of another family 15 minutes outside of London. We can write but not see each other in person again. I'm upset about this, but at least I know he's in safe care. The new family I'm staying with are named the Adams and they are of Jewish descent. The wife and husband are both very nice, however their son Lucas seems a bit off. Since I am 15, I'll be enrolled in school on Monday. Lucas is my age as well, so he will be in my class. My goal was to graduate university with a major in law, but I'm scared that that won't happen since I'm not staying in Austria anymore. The patriarch of the Adams family talked to me as if I was going to stay in England for a while. For the first time in my life, I have no clue what will become of me in the future. Should I be worried at all? The kids on the train say I was lucky to have been turning 16 in 2 months and are already 16, because I would have been in a hostel immediately. I hope all is well in grass. Tell Minnie I miss her and that she should stay calm since I won't be there for a while. Love, your daughter.
Thank you.
Many of the children's letters were returned to them as their parents were killed or deported to concentration camps.
If I were a little bird and had two little wings, I'd fly to you.
But since it can't be,
I remain here.
I'm just as far from you,
but I'm in a dream with you.
And talk with you.
When I do wake up, I am alone.
There's not an hour in the night
that my heart doesn't wake up
and think of you.
That more than a thousand times
you
give me your heart.